这次试验不仅用各种各样的仪器设备测量原子爆炸的情况，而且也安排了国防工程、动物和民防等试验项目。
At 1500 hours on October 16, 1964, the event which shocked the whole world finally takes place. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Our nation's first atomic bomb is a success. Atomic bomb designed and made by our own nation is a complete success. Nuclear test surpasses the levels of the first nuclear tests of the United States, Britain, and France. This is the result of the efforts of our nation's workers, engineers, technical personnel, scientists, officers and men of the People's Liberation Army, and all those concerned who willingly raised high the great red flag of Mao Zedong's thought, gave prominence to politics, creatively studied and used Chairman Mao's works, and concentrated their efforts to wage a battle of annihilation with united and vigorous cooperation. This is a gigantic success of Mao Zedong's thought. This is a gigantic success of the general line. Long live the Chinese Communist Party. Long live Chairman Mao. Personnel and cars entering the contaminated area of the explosion for recovery work are given strict examinations. These women comrades are glad to join the ranks of combat. Entering the contaminated area is an intense battle of racing against minutes and seconds to complete the task. Chairman Mao says, in our work, we must be enthusiastic but calm, and intense but orderly. See how intensely and earnestly they attend to their work. They successfully return. The people greet them intimately and warmly. In the afternoon of October 16, 1964, Premier Cho announces the news about our nation's successful experiment in testing its first atomic bomb. The nuclear monopoly and nuclear tyranny of the U.S. imperialists and the revisionists have been thoroughly bankrupted. Their criminal attempts to block and prevent our nation's people from grasping nuclear weapons have been thoroughly smashed. Work for the second nuclear test has begun. The comrades, not fearing hard labor and fatigue and continual fighting, are eagerly engaged in the new battle. The combat teams are given pre-combat political indoctrination to prepare for an intense struggle maneuver. At present, the U.S. imperialists are shifting their warlike strategy to Asia. They are maniacally expanding the war of aggression in Vietnam, and they are preparing to impose war on the heads of the Chinese people. Chairman Mao says, "The imperialists have humiliated us so severely that we must seriously take them to account. We must be prepared to fight early, to fight on a large scale, to fight great nuclear wars, to fight all kinds of war, and on several fronts." Another stimulating and jubilant day arrives on May 14th, 1965. Our nation successfully explodes its second nuclear bomb in the sky over the western part of our country. This is an extremely accurate, extremely successful explosion. This demonstrates the great results of cooperation among leaders, specialists, and the masses, and of the cooperation of education with research. This is another victory song for Mao Zedong's thought. To gain military experience under atomic conditions, the various tactical and maneuvering units enter the area of the explosion to conduct tactical maneuvers. Following Chairman Mao's teachings, they go forward without fear of sacrifices to overwhelm difficulties and grasp victory. Chairman Mao has always taught us that weapons are an important factor in war, but they are not the decisive factor. The decisive factor is not material, but man. Vice Chairman Lin Bao points out that under nuclear conditions, the greater the power is, the more intense the close fighting and night fighting would be. Regardless of offensives or defensives, the final decisive battle will be one of close combat at 100 or 200 meters. At that time, it will depend on who is tougher, who can take a position, who can hold it, who dares to see red on his bayonet. At that time, it will depend on one's proletariat.